A monochrome display says composite assembling unit. Ooh. Nothing to get, right? No. This is something we can use. I guess we have to use an item here. Assembling unit. Alright. Well, we'll remember that's there then. Please do not crumble at any moment. Not in the mood for your crumbling. I missed something, didn't I? Oh, right. Am I supposed to... It's a separated air circulation system. So do I have to close that and open this? And hopefully we're not going to suffer decompression or compression. I was right, it opens. It opens. What the hell is this noise now? With music? There's a strange tablet with a hexagonal hole in it. A hexagonal hole. You don't want this thing, do you? Wait. I didn't actually select it, did I? You're afraid to believe your own very eyes when you put the gem into the hole. Strong psychical energies fill the room as the crystal reveals the contents of its information cell, encoded more than 3 centuries ago. A very clear holographic image of a priest of toxic waste appears on the front wall, then a loud, aggressive, supernatural voice echoes down the hall. Banish the theory of equality, because the time has come for the mighty to rule and for the weak to serve. Taste my fury and remember, I am what I am. Then the hologram fades and the crystal disperses into dust. What? I am what I am. Who's this, Popeye? Didn't leave me anything. I suppose... Yeah, we just... There's no one to talk to. Or nothing to talk. It's a recording of the god of toxic waste. Well, that's interesting. Oh, I guess we can't open this. Yeah, we have to close the other door. So why is there a separate air system in that room? Does it keep the machine working correctly or something? Alright. We got more to explore. I think I missed some stuff behind me as well. Let me just go look behind me. I was thinking about signing off, but... So there's an elevator there, but we can also go this way. Maintenance and inspection quarter stands above the door. You see large wooden chests with the red writing explosives on them. Oh boy. Got explosives? object ahead. I'm guessing it's some explosives. Ooh. Axe splinter grenade. Well, Killdozer has a lot of stuff. Let's let Twin Snake get some stuff. You cannot carry more equipment without hindering your party's progress. Never mind, he's gonna take them. We have 4 grenades so far. 5. Composite key plug. Oh. Demolition pack. Oh, he's full. Dust filter mask. We're gonna need these masks. We got 3 masks so far. 4. Oh, he can't take it. Varanus. Advent. Alright, we got 5. Missing one for Runeclaw, but he can't carry anything else anyway. Well, if we need them, hopefully we find one more. Now we can analyze this stuff, right? Analyze one of these masks. Dust filter mass, 1.75 kilograms. Speed factor, 160%. Is that how fast you can put it on? Oh, it decreases your range defense for some reason. Well, because you have trouble seeing things flying at you, maybe? Physical protection, plus 5%. Organic and unorganic materials, resistance, plus 10. Radiation plus 15 and pathogens plus 5. Okay. So it's good against radiation to a certain extent. Not very much. It doesn't seem 15%, doesn't seem that great. Alright, well, unselect that. And then we have this, a composite key plug. I wish the, wish we had like little flavor text on these things. At least to give us an idea of what it's for. I guess that's the challenge. We don't know. 0.03 kilograms, 25% speed. Okay. That's something to be used somewhere. Sure, all will become clear. We have this grenade. Bunch of grenades. Let's look at one. Kilograms, speed factor 90%. Average wounding is 65, range 12, area 6. All classes can use, which I'm surprised about. I guess anyone could throw a grenade, right? Oh, what'd it say for range attack? Hold on. It looked like it said plus 90%. I wasn't really paying that close attention, but it just caught my eye. Yeah. Range attack plus 90%. Sweet. It might be meant to blow something up because we have other stuff. We have a demolition kit. Someone has a demolition kit. Here, demolition pack. Put this back. Oh, we saw this on the network terminal upstairs. Kobold dynamic mineral demolition grenade. Looks like this is supposed to say other things, but I can't tell. Maybe it's Braille. All users, 3.25 kilograms, speed factor 90%, Kobold details. Oh, there's actual... Nice, we got flavor text, I asked for that. Explosives marked with Kobold identification code are used to crack through thin layers of stone and rock to reach the actual level of useful fissile materials. Fissile? Fissile? I think it's fissile. This version of Kobold requires a dynamic timing mechanism, which at default setting allows you to reach the safe distance within 6 seconds after ignition. Safety requirements. Fire door dot class CC2. Yeah, that's what the terminal said. For all I know, the terminal said all this as well. But it's good to have a reminder. It's just something we can carry around with us as well. Alright, let's deselect it. Alright, good. Okay. Shall we see where this goes? Let's save. I guess this is a three-parter. Because I'm keeping going. It goes down. It was that song again. Or theme. Piles of small rusty tubes and wires cover the floor of this chamber. Object and network detector. A titanium plaque indicates energy cell rechargers. A ceremonial helmet? What? Amulet of Domination. That sounds sweet. I think Runeclaw wants it if he can carry it. Sweet, that's awesome. Alright. So, I definitely want to see what this does. Is this for use against your enemies? Amulet of Domination, 0.20 kilograms, speed factor 75%. Psionic Knight and Mercenary and Assassin can use. I think Runeclaw's a psionic. Requires intelligence 60, concentration 50. 60 and 50. Let me just write this down. You know, I'm gonna invert it in my head or something. Psionic, question mark. Intelligence 60. Concentration 50. Physical attack and defense plus 20% minus 15% operation time for some reason, plus 10% physical protection, mental action time minus 20, and mental attack plus 30. So you have less time to cast your spells, but you have, they'd be more devastating once you do use them. And then the following resistances. Oh, it's good against radiation. It's better with radiation than the masks are, at least according to this, what I'm looking at. So he should be wearing this, since he doesn't have the mask. He'll be safer than everyone else, I think. So do we put it... I recommend that you try that item. That item somewhere else. Oh, it goes on top of your... Okay. So he's got the light armor. He's got the tunic with the light armor on top, but he can also have that. Amulet of Domination. It's more like an amulet of protection. Alright, who picked up the other stuff? Yeah, this thing I definitely want to look at. Ceremonial Helmet. Well, I'm guessing he can use it. Let me put it on. I forgot to even check. 4.33 kilograms. Speed factor 90%. Minimal required values is concentration 60. Mediator, psionic, and anchorite. The basic spellcasting, quote-unquote, classes. Alright, so let me just write this. Helmet. 60 concentration. Physical protection plus 10%. Range attack and defense go down. Mental action time goes down. But attack and defense protection energy go up. Radiation plus 5%, even more. So it'll help out the mask, right? I'm guessing it's going to be something like as we walk along, will take damage with either every step or every few steps or something like that, or it could be random, like the speed increases a certain amount of times, like pseudo-random. That's what my guess is. Well, he can't wear it because he's not one of these classes. I do want to look at Runeclaw's stats, though. He is a psionic, okay. And then his intelligence is supposed to be... Oh, what's going on with his strength? Oh, we need to rest. I wonder if you can ever fail to rest. Or get interrupted. Doesn't seem like you can. Alright, so his intelligence needs to be at least 60. We got 84, and his concentration is supposed to be 50. We got 118. So he's good for wearing that, obviously. I mean, otherwise he wouldn't have been able to put it on. Alright, so to the equipment. Piranus, possibly? He's got the least vitality, quote-unquote, hit points. And he's a mediator. I'm pretty sure that's one of the ones. Alright, so all we have is this hood, but now we got... Now we got a ceremonial helmet and a hood. Good. Did we pick up anything else? Was that it? I think we picked up a few things. Just going back, just going forward through. Just cycling through. Demolition pack. I started giving some things to Twin Snake, right? I just want to make sure there's nothing that I missed out on. He already has this military armor, or elite troop armor is even better. Yeah, I think that's one of the ones, one of the things I wanted to try to sell is the military armor, but oh, here, he needs to reload this thing anyway. Cool, and we have another one. So we have 5 ammo, another 5 ammo there, and that's it. They want to check through the guns. He has 16. 16 here. Only three there. That machine gun's empty. He's only got 4. And no refill, unfortunately. Killdozer going physical. He's got that. Alright, and these are good. Okay. See, now that I did all this work, this tubular recharger device bears the rune which stands for I. So nothing here, no object, so we've got to use an item here, I guess. Tubular recharger device. It's recharging what? The ceiling is filled with ancient ritual runes of Lord Toxic Waste. This rune stands for AM. I am. What? What I am? Huh? What I am. So if this is some kind of puzzle, I think we gotta say what I am. So we gotta hit this one. And then that one, which is I. And then M. But I'm not sure. Energy cell rechargers. We don't have anything like that, right? I mean, the closest thing like that, I think, is Twin Snake has these ammo things. It's a power card, though, not an energy cell. That's not this thing, that's a plug. Grenades. Pass card. Empty code battery? And these grenades. And the drill. No driller. Empty code battery. It's empty. Maybe we're supposed to recharge it. This is I. That's M, I mean. The battery sparks for a second under the penetrating energy stream. put in all. That's still an empty code battery. It says it sparks. Is that supposed to mean something to me, that it sparks? Or is it just some flavor text? Well, interesting. That's where that goes. And then we've been down here. That's where we found the other goodies. Alright, this is, yeah. That thing. And then down here is... we found... creating device or something, yeah. I forgot what they called it. It wasn't called creating device. Yeah, please don't grumble on me. It's a composite assembling unit. Alright, so that's where that thing is there. Out here to the main hall. I've got a way down there. You have reached the end of this descending shaft. Indeed I have. Area gate locking system number 2. You're unable to open this door. Well, that's why we still have the card. Pass card easily opens this heavy door. There's a dust-covered, barely visible screen and a tubular-shaped hole. There is a tubular-shaped hole. Do we have a tubular thing to use? This? The code battery, maybe? Nothing special happens at all. At all. I'm gonna put the grenades in there. What about the plug thing? I'm not supposed to put the drill in there, that'd be weird. Plug. Anything else? Nope. Alright, we'll try that. We might not have the item that we're supposed to use in there. It's not that. Thank you. don't know what we're supposed to use there. Maybe something we don't have yet. Faded out screens, right? An almost unreadably small stainless steel table says what's it say? Something ink. You see the outlet of a harmless sensor coordinating laser here. Really? Well, it's nothing we can pick up. I wonder what we're supposed to do with the laser. Shoot something at the end of the hall? Can we see what this says again? It won't say. It won't repeat the text. The door remains totally motionless. Are we supposed to close this door? So we can open this door? Yes. We know that trick now, don't we? Oh, another harmless sensor coordinating laser. Huh. That is really interesting. Okay. Our way forward is this way. But gonna call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.